Welcome to Nav Classes. Please do subscribe if you didn't yet and ring the bell with subscribe button to get notified next time as and when I upload my new video. And now onwards you will get these PDF notes under comment section and under description box. You can find them here and do practice these questions. Today I'm gonna teach new pattern syllogisms under which we will cover reverse syllogs and coded symbolic syllogs, which is nowadays in RRB PO exams. So let's see, all the best for exams who are going to prepare this one. Okay, firstly let's see question number one. Here is the conclusion and statements. This is reverse syllogs. As per conclusion, firstly we are going to read conclusion, and as per them we will see whether these statements are following or not, whether these conclusions are extracted out of these statements or not. Okay, so let's see. This is first one is of not, it means first one is negative and second one is positive, and any statement having no negative we will reject that particular. Here we can see all statements are having negative, it means having no in one statement. So otherwise we will go by elimination method and we will just eliminate that particular in which there is no negative, because we know there should be particular negative statement to merge them and to get that negative conclusion. Here we can see there is no such case, so we have to consider all these statements. Let's see, here it is asking about some bats are not rat. So if we see, here is some dogs are rat. So as per that we have to make a relation between bats and rats. So here if we see, there is dog and rat and rat and cat. So as per 150 rule I written this particular, and if you wanna see, bat is, this is rat and this is bat. So we have to merge this cat and cat. Can we merge them? Both are having 100 and 100, total is 200. Yes, we can easily merge them. And can bat give 50 out of 50? Yes. Can rat give 100 out of 50? Yes. So this particular conclusion is satisfying with help of this statement. So let us see for the next conclusion. Next is some cat are rat. This is positive. So there is no positive relationship between cat and rat. This is negative one, so it can't possible. Next statement is saying no rat is cat. Here again we will just deduct all with no, because we require positive relation between cat and rat. In statement number D, no cat is bat and all cat are rat. Yes, this particular is positive, and if we see whether it is following or not, then there is 50 with cat and 100 with rat. Can they give 50 and 50 out of 150? Yes, can give. So this particular conclusion is satisfying from here. Let us see first one. Here is bat and we require to make relation between rat and bat. So there is cat, cat common. Can this be merged? Yes, this can be merged. Can bat give 50 out of 100? Yes. Can rat give 100 out of 100? Yes. So this particular conclusion is also following with help of this statement. So we can clearly say that D is following. Next, see, all red is blue is possibility. This is the case of possibility. What do we do in case of possibility? We make statements. After merging, we will make statements, and out of that we will see whether the possibility is existing or not. So red is here and blue is here. Here is yellow, yellow, which is common. Let us see, can we merge them or not? Here is 50 and 100 as per 150 rule. There is no need to write this 50, 100. You can easily see. By now you practiced a lot and you can easily see whether this is following, whether this is merging or not. Okay. All red are having 100 and blue are having 50. So there is positive relation in both statements. Both statements are positive, so there must be all relationship. There is not some not relationship, because both statements are positive. As per all red are blue, there are no possibility if you are going from red to blue. If you are coming from blue to red, it means if you are going A to B, no possibility is existing. And if you go B to A as per our notes, then two type of possibilities are here, all and some not. And this is all, it means this is following. Next is green being yellow is possibility. Let us see the relationship between green and yellow. Where is green? Green is here and yellow is here. So we have to merge this blue blue. Can we merge? Yes, we can merge because total is 150. We can merge yellow and green. Okay. So these are having 100 and 100. We already understood that in case of no, there is no possibility. No possibility is existing in that case. So that is wrong in that case. Let us see. This will be easy for us if we continue by second conclusion first. So here it is green and yellow. Yellow is here and green is here again. Let us see. Can we merge them? Yes, we can merge them as per 150. So there is 150 and we can merge them. After merging, we have 100 with yellow and 50 with green. This is one negative, one positive. It means this is the relationship of sum not. So we have this sum green are not yellow. This is the relationship which we forgot here, 50 and 100. Now, in case of sum not, which are the possibilities? In case of sum nots, if you go by A to B, if you go from green to yellow, then only sum and no possibilities existing. It is going from green to yellow. But if you would go from other side, then all type of possibilities were existing. But here in case, in this case, this is the conclusion with all. So this is not following. Even if one conclusion is not following, that means you will wrong the statement. Okay. Let us see another one. Some red is yellow. Okay, green and yellow. Let us see in this one only. So here is green and here is yellow. Can we merge them? Yes, we can merge them. Because total is 150, we can merge them, 50 and 100, okay. And after that, we have yellow with 50 and green with 100 because of no. With green, this is 100. So Y is having 50 and green is having 100. It means it is the relationship of sum not. Because of there is one negative statement, so this is the negative relation of sum not. If we see from G to Y, it is asking about from G to Y. All type of possibilities are existing in case of sum not. Okay, whether it is of all, no, sum not, no, all type of possibilities are existing in this case. Hence, this is correct as per this statement. Let us see about red and blue. Possibility red is here and blue is here. Can we merge yellow and yellow? No, we cannot merge yellow and yellow because of their 50-50. It means in total we require 150 and 200. We cannot merge them. It means if we cannot merge them, then all type of possibilities are existing here. If there is no relationship between statements, then we already understood in our golden rule that all type of possibilities are existing here. So both conclusions are following as per this statement. So we can say that this is correct. Let us see another one. All red is yellow. Okay, let us see first green and yellow relation. Can we merge blue and blue? Yes, we can easily merge blue and blue. Yellow is having 100 and green is having 50 because of all. It means this is negative relation. It is the relationship of sum not. If it is sum green R not Y, then in this case from G to Y, it is asking about from green to yellow. No and some possibilities are existing. This is all. It means this is not possible. So this is wrong. If one conclusion is wrong, then your statement is wrong. Okay. So both conclusions should follow in this case. Next is simple question without any possibility. Let us see. This is no. It means there must be negative relation in one statement. So if we see, we can follow the elimination rule first. Because there is no and no, this can be answered. There is no and there is no. It means we have to go through all these. Because there is no in all case. So there is no elimination rule is following. Let us see about first one first. Tulip and lily. Tulip and lily are here. We have to merge rose. Rose, can we merge? Yes. Tulip are having 50 and lily are having 100. So can lily spend 100 out of 100? Yes. Tulip can spend 50 out of 100? Yes. After that, let us see second conclusion. Sum flowers are rows. Flowers are here and rows are here. We have to merge tulip and tulip. Can be merged? Yes, because total is 150. We require 150 or 200. This can be merged. So rows having 100, rows is having 100, and it rows can spend 50 out of 100 and flower can spend 50 out of 100. So both conclusion are following as per first statement. So A is our answer in over here. If you want to go further, then you can go. Otherwise, there is no need because there are no other options. Otherwise, this is the answer. As per next statement, we have to search for the relationship between tulip and lily. Rose is common. Can we merge them? Yes. Can tulip spend 50 out of 100? Yes. Can lily spend 100 out of just 50? Not possible. This is wrong here. Let us see another one. Here, tulip is here and lily is here. We have to... Okay, this one is in one... Okay, it's in one statement. So as per this, in case of no, lily is tulip. Can lily spend, this is 100 and 100 in case of no. Okay, can lily spend 100 out of 100? Yes, tulip can spend 100 out of 100. Yes, so it is following. Let us see another one. We have to search the relationship between rose and flower. Rose is here and flower is here. We have to merge all these statements. Can we merge them? One more thing is here. We have to merge all these statements. And there is no tulip and tulip. These statements is negative. No, there is no. If we have to get positive conclusion, then these statements must be positive. We cannot get a positive conclusion out of one negative. There is one with positive, next is negative, and another next is negative. So in case of even one single negative, your conclusion must be negative. Here you are getting positive conclusion in your question. So it is not possible. Let us see another one. Here also, if you want to make relationship between flower and rose. Flower and rose, you have to merge these two negative. This particular is negative. So you have to merge this tulip, and then you will merge this lily and lily. Then you will be able to reach rose and flower. It means you cannot do that because there is one negative statement. If you want to merge any statement which is having negative, then your conclusion must be negative. Here in question it is positive. So third answer is A. Third question's answer is A. Next question is asking about possibility case. In case of possibility, we have to make statements. So let us see simple question first. If it is following, then we will reach to the possibility because that is a longer process. Here it is negative. Okay. So in ocean and lake, there must be negative relationship. This is positive one and another one is also positive. So we will eliminate this here only. Here the elimination rule is following. Here lake must be positive. There must be negative relation in those these two statements to get negative answer. So here it is also not following. There is all and there is no. Okay, this can possible because there is no in one statement. So if we merge positive and negative, we will get negative conclusion. Let us see ocean and lakes. Here water is common. Can we merge them? Yes, because of 150, this is 150. We can merge them. Lake is having 100 and ocean is having 100. Can lake spend 100 out of 100? Yes. Can ocean spend 50 out of 100? Yes. One conclusion is following. Let us see for possibility case here. It is asking about water and river is possibility. Here we have to make the relationship between river and water. Okay. And ocean is common. Can we merge this ocean? Yes, because of this no, there is 100 and 50. Total is 150. Okay, we can merge them. And water is having 100 and river is having 50. This is compiling of negative and positive statements. So this must be the case of sum not. In case of sum not, if you go by river to water, then two possibilities are here, sum and no. But if you go from water to river, then all type of possibilities are here. All type of possibility in case of reverse. So here you can clearly say that all water being river is possibility is correct. So both conclusion are following as per C statements. So yes, this is your answer. If you want to go further, you can go. Otherwise, it's okay. Let me see another one for your information. it is asking about ocean and lakes. All statements are positive. It cannot be possible to get negative conclusion out of that. Let us see another concept. This is about symbolic syllogisms or coded syllogisms. Here what you gonna do is, firstly you will make a particular table as per given symbols. I will teach you how to do that. Then you will follow three steps. In first step you will see each statements and you want to make relationship between them. If there is need to combine them, then can we combine with the 100? There must be 100. It means this is the general rule of combination. If there is 100, then we can combine. If not able to combine, then we will just reject your conclusion here only. Then let's see, if you go further, then see the relation. If the conclusion is asking about positive relation, can we have positive relation from these statements? We will see that. If not, we will reject here. If yes, we will go to third step. I will tell you how to make these relationships. Then see 150 rule, whether 150 rule is following or not. As per 150 rule, income expenditure, can this particular person can spend 100 out of 50 or cannot spend 100 out of 50? So these you are going to search for. When we solve questions, you will be able to get these answers. Now this is the question here. Here you are going to make a table first. Percentage means this is some case. It means this is positive. Here is the relationship between them. This is positive relation. And then as per that, you are going to write down for the 150 quotations for them. Like in case of some, this is 50-50 case. You are going to write down 150 rule over here for this P and Q. Then for hash, you have sum not relation. It means sum not means negative relation. You will write sum not means 50 under P and not means 100 under Q. This is very important to see carefully whether it is 100 in case of P or Q. Okay, here you can see and. Here Q is having 50 and P is having, see carefully, P is having not. It means P is having 100. So we will write like so, and this is like a negative relation. Next is dollar all case. All P or Q. All P or Q means P is having 100 and Q is having 50. Next is at the rate. P at the rate Q means no P is Q. No P is Q means 100 and 100 relationship and that too negative. So you will make this table like so. Now we will come to our questions and we will try to solve them with help of this 150 rule. So here you are going to write their respective 150s. Firstly, as per statement, there is no need to make any Venn diagram. A and B means, and means 150. You will denote 100 to A and 50 to B. Let us see dollar. Dollar means 150 again. So you have to write down 100 over here under B. So B is having 100 and C is having 50. For percentage, you have some relation, that is 50-50. There is 50 already in case of C. Let me write down for D. Then there is hash, 50-100. Okay, in case of D, there is 50 and we will write 100 under E. As per this, see conclusion number 1, C at the rate D. And here it is asking about C and D. Firstly, you have to see whether there is a 100 relation or not. And then you will see at the rate means negative. There must be negative relation in among these two statements. And as per negative, it must be 100 and 100 with C and D. So if you want to see here, C and D cannot be combined because these are having 50 and 50. You require at least 100 over here to combine. So first is not following, and secondly it is percentage means positive, so there is no negative. So both conditions are not following over here, so you will reject that. E hash B means 50-100. Hash means negative relation must be there, and 50-100. And firstly we are going to see for 100 relations. Let's see, E is here and B is here. Can we combine these 100 and 50? Yes, we can combine. Can we combine C and D? After that you have to see whether you combine C and D. No, because these are having 50-50. There is no even a single 100 with C or D. So it cannot be combined over here. To reach from E to B, you have to combine these all statements. That is not possible in this case. There is 50-50 over here. So you cannot combine. Here first condition is not satisfying. Even you can see first condition is not satisfying, you will reject this conclusion over here only. You will not go further over here. Let us see B percent D. Percent means positive relation must be there, and as per positive relation there must be 50-50 relation over there. Firstly, let us see about there must be positive relation and 50-50 must be there as per percentage. There must be 50. Okay, then D is here and B is here. Can we combine C and D? No, because there is no even a single 100 over here. In case of C and D, there is no 100. So first step is not satisfying. We are not going to go further over here. Let us see another one. Fourth, A percent C. A percent C, percent means positive relation must be there, and then there must be 50-50 relation. Okay, A is here and C is here. Can we combine B and C first? We have to combine in between. Then there is 100 over here with B. Yes, we can combine. Can we combine A and B? Yes, there is 100 over here with A. We can combine. So yes, first condition is satisfying over here. Let us see, this is positive relation must be there. As per AND, you can see there is negative relation. So this cannot follow. Because as per second step, there must be positive relation among these all statements. Even if even a single statement is having negative, then we cannot get positive conclusion out of that. Let us see A and C. A is here, C is here, and means negative relation must be there. And as per negative relation, 150 must be there, 100 with A, 50 with C. Let us see first, can we combine them? Yes, we can combine, where because there is 100 among these statements. So yes, we can combine. First is satisfying and is having negative. So yes, this is another which is satisfying. Let us go to another step. 150. Can A span 100 out of 100? Yes, A can span. We can clearly see that there is 100 with A. Can C span 50 out of 50? Yes, this is also possible. So this is your conclusion. Here, 50 is your conclusion in this case. Now, second question. Again, same statement. Let us denote 150 first. A and B means 150. Dollar means 150. 100 with A, 50 with C. Percent means 50-50. There is already 50, so I am writing 50 under D. Hash means 50-100. There is 50 with D and we are writing 100 over here with E. Now let us see for B hash D. Hash means there must be negative. 100 condition is there first step, and on the third step there must be 150. Let us see 100 condition first. From B to D, we have to go from B to D. If you want to merge this C and D first, then we cannot merge because there is 50-50. Can we merge them? No, we cannot merge because there is 50-50. We require at least 100 to merge them. So this first step is not satisfying. So we will reach toward another conclusion. There is not satisfaction in first conclusion. E hash A. We have to go from E to A. Even here we can see we cannot go from E to A, so that is not possible. Let us see another one. A hash D. Okay, A from D, we can see we cannot merge C and D, so we can cancel it here only. D hash A. D is here and A is here. Again we can see C and D cannot be merged because of 100 required over here, so this cannot be merged. So we will reach to another conclusion. This is wrong. C percent B. C is here and B is here. Okay, let us see. C percent means there must be positive relationship. We are going to see for this 100 one. There must be positive relationship. And then that to 50-50. Okay. If we go from C to B, C is having 50 and B is having 100. Yes, we can merge them. First is satisfying. Positive. Dollar means positive. Yes, this is also satisfying. Can B spend 50 out of 100? Yes, C can spend 50 out of 100. So this particular is following. So this is your answer. Question number 3. As per this, this is the longer one. Let us make this relation first. A percent B means plus, that to 50-50. Let us write down 50-50. Dollar means 150. And means 150. So we are writing 100 over here and 50. D is having 50. Again, dollar means 150. It means D must be 100, so I am writing over here, and E must be 50, so I am writing over here. Percentage means 50-50, so there is 50 with E, so let me write for F. There is F with 50, and then here is dollar 150, so let me write down 100 over here and 50 over here. So this is the relationship which we are able to get here. Let us see G dollar C. Dollar means there must be positive relationship. And firstly, we are going to see whether we can reach with help of this 100 or not. Then there must be positive, and another one must be 150 as per G and C. Firstly, let me see, can we reach till C or not? From G to F, we can combine, yes. From F to E, we can combine, because at least one F is having 100, okay. Can we combine D and E? Yes, there is 100 with D. We can combine D and E as well. Now let us see for C and D. So there is at least 100 with F, so that is why we can combine it. D and D can combine because there is 100. C and D we can combine because there is 100 with C. Okay, so this is satisfying. Positive. Let us see, dollar is positive, okay. Percentage is positive, okay. And is negative. Here it is not following. And is negative, so this cannot give you a positive conclusion. So this is wrong. It means we have to search for another conclusion. This is wrong. We will not go to third step now. A at the rate E. At the rate means there must be negative conclusion. Firstly, we are going to see for 100. And as per negative, there must be 100-100 relation. Let us see, from A to E, we can reach. Okay, can we merge this D and E? Yes. C and D? Yes, there is 100. B and C, there is 100. And A and B? Yes, B is having 100. So we can merge them. First is satisfying over here. And let us see for negative 1. Percentage means positive. Dollar means positive. And means negative. So this is also following. Let us see, can A spend 100 out of 50? Not possible. Cannot spend 100 out of just 50. This is wrong here. Let us see E, percentage D. Percentage is having positive relation, and that too of 50-50. So let us see. Firstly, we are going to search for the 100 one. Can we combine them or not? E is here and G is here. Yes, we can combine. We already understood that. We can combine. Positive relation. Dollar means positive, yes. Percent means positive, yes. So this is also following. 50-50. Can E spend 50 out of 50? Yes. G can 50 out of 50? Yes. So all conditions are satisfying. So your answer is third. D at the rate A. At the rate means negative relation must be there. 100 rule is following. Yes, we already understood that these all are following. So these all can be combined. So we already understood that. There must be negative relationship. If we see, and means negative. So yes, this is negative. After that, you have to see for 100 and 100 because of this negative. So A is having only 50. Can spend 100 out of 50? Not possible. So this is wrong here. F at the rate C. This is very important part. Just listen carefully. There must be negative, and we are going to search for 101. And as per negative, 100-100 rule must be there. Can we merge this F and C? Okay, we are going to go from F to C. So can we merge this E and F? See carefully, I am writing this again. C and D, D dollar E, E percent F. So you have to go from C till F. You cannot go and you cannot see this 154 another one, because this is because of here it is 50-50 for E and F. There is not 100 over here because this statement is ending over here only. You cannot go for this dollar sign because this 100 is for dollar. 150 is for dollar. So that 150 is for F dollar G. It is not till F. So it is coming after F relation. Okay, so you cannot go for that. Your relationship must be till here, from C till F. Whatever you are getting, you can search as per that. If there is 50 with F and 50 with E, you cannot merge them. So first step is not following. So here you will cancel it out. So this is not following. You will not go further over here. I hope you understand. Here it was asking about till F. Let us see another one, that your confusion will vanish. E percent B. Percent means there must be positive relation, 50-50 relation. Let us see, can we merge E and B? Can we merge E and D? Yes. Can we merge D and C? Yes. Can we merge B and C? Yes. So we can merge these all. There must be positive relationship. Dollar is having positive and is having negative. And is having negative. So it is not following. So this is not your answer. Let us see another one. C percent A. C percent A. Can we merge? It means it is having 100. And again B is having 100 over here. So it can be merged. So this is following over here. Next is percentage means positive relation must be there. So there is percent with plus and dollar with plus. Yes, this is positive relation. This is following. Percentage means there must be 50 and 50. Can C spend 50 out of 50? Yes. Can A spend 50 out of 50? Yes. So this is your answer here. Let us see another one for clarification. F at the rate D. At the rate means negative relation must be there. 100-100 must be there. And let us see first, can we merge them or not. This is asking about till F. This is not asking about further F. Till F, we are having only 50. Can we merge F and E? No, it is not possible because total of them is just 100. We require 150 or 200. It means at least 100 must be there. It is not possible. So here it is wrong. B and E. B is here and E is here. E is having 50 and D is having, yes, 100. So it can be merged. It can be merged again till B and C. It is merging. First condition is satisfying. Then at the rate means negative must be there and 100-100 must be there. Dollar is having positive relation and is having negative relation. So yes, this condition is also satisfying. But can B spend 100 out of 100? Yes. Can E spend 100 out of just 50? It is not satisfying. So hence here fourth is wrong. B at the rate D. 100-100 is following because there is 100 in these statements to merge them. Yes. Then there must be negative relation and is having negative. It is also following. Then can B spend 100 out of 100? Yes. Can D spend 100 out of just 50? If you have to see till D, you cannot go further D. Till D, you have this 50. There is 100 because of this dollar. We are not going further D. Till D, you have 50 only. So, out of 50, D cannot spend 100. So, this is not following over here. So, here it is wrong because of this conclusion. Now, let us make another 150 relation. Dollar means 150 and means 150. Percent means 50-50. Can we combine this B and D? B and D. B is having negative relation, that too of 150. So you have to get this one. Firstly, let us see, can we combine them or not. B is here and D is here. Can we combine C and D? No, because of their 50-50. There is not even a single 100. We cannot combine them. This is wrong. D percent C. Percent means positive relation must be there. 50-50 must be there. Let us see combinations first. D and C. This C, listen carefully here. This is asking about this only. There is no need to combine because there is C percent D in one statement. Okay, there is no need to combine many statements to reach from D to C. There is no need to go from one particular to far away C. This is near about. C person D is here only. Can now in this case there is no need to get this 100 rule because this is in one statement. There is no need to combine several statements to get there. Now we have to analyze this only. C percentage D is asking about positive, yes, positive, 50-50 is there, 50-50, yes, this is following. One more thing to understand, to clear your concept, if the conclusion would asking about C percent D only, conclusion would asking about C percent D only and there is C percent D in your statement. Here, it is repeating exactly same in conclusion. So, in that case, this should be invalid. In that case, this is invalid. Here, it is not invalid because here it is coming from D to C. If it would going from C to D only in conclusion, it means same as it is repeating in the conclusion, then in that case, this must be invalid. So, this is to clear your concepts here. It is invalid. Let us see A percent. C percent means there must be positive and 50-50 relation must be there. Firstly, let me see, can we combine them? Yes, we can combine because of 100 over here and there is 100, so we can combine that. Now, let us see relation. Dollar means positive, yes, and means negative, so this is wrong because we require positive relation. It is not possible to get positive conclusion out of one single negative statement. Okay, this is wrong. B and A. B dollar A. Dollar means plus. Okay, B dollar A, it is in one. So first plus means dollar, yes, it is satisfying. Can B spend? This is still here only. Remember again, we are not going further from B to C, B and C. So this is still here. So B is having just 50. B cannot spend 100 out of 50. This is wrong here. So this is not following because of this problem. Let us see D dollar B. See carefully, just clear this concept. We were going from B to E only. We cannot go and B and C. 100 is with and. B and C, there is 100. Okay, we cannot go further. From D to B, we cannot reach because of C and C percentage D. There is 50-50 with C percentage D. So, we cannot go for that. A step is not following. Hence, we can say this is wrong. Fifth is wrong. So, here your answer is second. Today, we learn how to solve reverse syllogisms and symbolic or coded syllogisms. Okay, with help of 150 rule. There is no need to make any Venn diagram over here. Today, we are able to complete full syllabus of syllogisms for all competitive exams. Okay, so if you want to get these PDF notes, yes, today I provided this link in description box to download PDF notes. Please do subscribe. When you click on Nav Classes, you will reach to my channel. Here is this bell icon. Remember to click this bell icon to get notified. And under video column, you will get all my videos. Under playlist, you will get all playlists for respective topic. And you can search whether in English or Hindi. Thank you.